be the middle of winter, but on weekends it looks a lot like the middle of August at the Iowa State Fairgrounds.
News Channel 8's Cynthia Fodor shows us tonight that the state fairgrounds have become a hot spot all year round.
Kevin and Stacy, they're not frying funnel cakes in February here, but three buildings have brought new life to the fairgrounds in the winter.
Last weekend, for the first time, Bacon Fest brought 5,000 people here. While they chowed down on pork inside the Varied Industries building, thousands of others attended the Beef Expo and an antique show also on the fairgrounds.
It was a lot of fun to see it, and especially it's so odd when there's snow on the ground, and usually we're used to seeing our hot August days have all the activity, but it's happening year-round now.
That's exactly what they had in mind when the fair enclosed the 1911 Varied Industries building in 2002 to make it a year-round facility. It now attracts major trade shows. The Jacobson Exhibition Center, which opened in 2010, has become much more than a horse arena. It will host a hairball concert this Saturday night, and for the first time, a national wrestling tournament next weekend.
We're hosting the NAIA Wrestling Championships, which for Des Moines in particular, that's exciting because Grandview is helping to host it, and they're ranked number one in wrestling.
And the Animal Learning Center, which opened in 2007, is bringing in even more people. They're laying out auction items and setting up tables for a weekend of scrapbooking.
We chose the fairgrounds for the proximity and ease for everybody to get here, plus of the beautiful building that it is, and just a great chance for people to get together in one room, which was something that we were looking for.
With the new buildings and easy parking, more than 200 other events are now being held here besides the big one.
Plus, it's just always fun to come out to the fair, whatever time of year it is.
We are already counting down the days, hours, minutes, and seconds to the Iowa State Fair, but in the meantime, you'll find lots to do here.
So if you're into scrapbooking, fishing, boating, or good old rock and roll, head to the fairgrounds this weekend. Stacy and Kevin.
Thank you, Cynthia. By the way, Greg Edwards of the Des Moines Convention and Visitors Bureau told Cynthia that the Jacobson Center, as you saw there, has been a big draw for many new events. He says Des Moines, as a matter of fact, now on the short list for the National Junior High Rodeo Championships.